Nilaadri, please start with your presentation.
Okay, good evening, everyone. So my topic today is role of liposomes as novel drug delivery approach. It is a trending topic. So finally, first of all, I want to start what are liposomes. Liposomes are wellly vesicles which are mainly spherical in shape and have one or more phospholipid layers, like which are mainly acting as drug delivery systems, and in it can be also used in medical and pharmaceutical research. It was mainly found by Alec Bangham of Abraham Institute in Cambridge, 1965, England. So mainly the liposomes can vary in size and shape, but it is actually the main diameters of maximum F2 liposomes are 50 to 300 nm. They can be manufactured in different types of forms, different types of through different types of routes, and they can also encapsulate hydrophilic and hydrophobic forms effectively as the type of insoluble drug, and it can be also used in non-toxic vehicles as there is amphipathic property in the liquid. So mentioning about the applications, liposomes have several applications. Like it is given here, we can target the tumors like in the blood-borne neoplasms, in RAS cancers, in targeting the passive liver of liver and spleen. It can also help in target of localized drug effect. Then also in gene therapy, like in gene therapy, in recent times, the recombinant gene therapy, the fragments of DNA are transferred into a cell where gene alters happen, and we can see there are some certain changes and certain proteins and polypeptides are made in that. Then it can also act as carriers of vaccines. It can also reduce the toxicity as it is site specific, and it is targeted, or also it is active in other places like food agro-based industry, cell liposome industry, and etc. Then it can classify it in mainly in three types, like on structural features. We can classify it in multilamellar, unilamellar, and oligolamellar, etc. On composition, we can classify it in pH sensitive, like cationic and conventional, etc. And for the preparation purpose, we classified it various, like extrusion method, then reverse phase evaporation method, ether injection method, thin film hydration method, etc. So talking about the mechanism of action, as we know that these liposomes can contain, liposome can give out both hydrophilic and lipophilic molecules. So the physicochemical characters and the composition of lipid may decide the extent of the drug where it will locate. Now the liposomal content is released when the lipid bilayers gets fused with the bilayers of the cell, and the next cell, the liposomal contents of the drug molecules are released in the site of action. Mainly the mechanism follows four steps, like here, which is given here: adsorption, endocytosis, fusion, and lipid exchange. So adsorption is mainly when the contact of the cell membrane is done with the cell membrane, so it is mainly due to the adsorption. Then in endocytosis, there's engulfment of engulfment and internalization into the liposomes. Fusion, there's lateral diffusion and intermingling, which ultimately helps in the binding of bilayers of liposomes with the lipid membrane. Then we move to lipid exchange, where there is exchange of proteins as done mainly, which causes this lipid exchange. Then I can here give an example, like in cancer cells, you can see that a number of fats which are required for their growth. So when we charge a liposomal drug, the cancer cells target them as a nutrition, and they ultimately take it, and finally the liposomal content kills the cancer cells. So there are some here are some methods, like where we use the liposomal formulations, like thin film hydration, where we can make like 5-fluorouracil, celecoxib, adriamycin, etc. Then also there are some other methods like ether injection, which I already mentioned, and sonication, from where streptomycin like antibodies are made. Antibiotics are made mainly. Also, it has some certain advantages. Liposomes have certain advantages and disadvantages, which is here given that it should be biocompatible. It is biocompatible. It should be non-toxic. It should have a controlled hydration method. It should here the water and lipid soluble drugs can be carried out. It should have different types of routes through which the liposomes can be transferred. And also, macro and micro molecule incorporated should be done. So some disadvantages are also done. It has less solubility, it has less stability. Also, the production cost of this process is also high in these recent times. And also,
Shekhar, conclude it.
Okay, so
Yeah.
Sir, am I done or?
Yeah. Go for conclusion.
Okay. Sir, to conclude, we can say that in the future advancement, the PDT and phototrigger-able scopes are there. Where if the phototrigger in the PDT therapy, it is due to there certain advancement, but actually PDT is hydrophobic property, which is not certainly advanced. So it has less solubility, so we cannot use it for like advanced treatment of cancers. But if in future it is it gets betterment, so we can use it in the treatment of cancers and other aspects.
Okay. Okay, Shekhar. Good, very good. Next, I have three questions for you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What is the basic structure of a liposome?
Sir, it should have a like phosphatidylated bilayer and it should have a phosphatidylated.
Otherwise, give me a formulation of liposome.
Sir, formulations are, sir, it can like in the market, it is found that doxylurban, adriamycin, then it can be used as for cosmetics like triptoin, like which is used in L'Oreal, which is used by L'Oreal, and also some doxic PM, which is the doxorubicin formulation, sir.
Okay. So, can you tell me any evaluation test for liposomes?
Sir, what? Can I repeat the question, please?
Evaluation test for liposomes.
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay, this Shekhar. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.